10 years from now, everyone will be getting a blood test at exactly the right age. And it will tell them whether they may be on their way to Alzheimer's. We will have readily available, safe, affordable drugs or even natural products that prevent Alzheimer's disease early in life.
Rudy Tanzi is an American neurologist whose discoveries have reshaped how we understand neurodegenerative disease. In this episode, he'll tell us how new medications are being developed that could change the future of Alzheimer's treatment.
Hi, Rudy. Welcome to the HumanWare Project. Could you, in a simplest term, tell us what is Alzheimer's disease?
Well, Alzheimer's is the most common form of dementia in the elderly, causing catastrophic decline in cognition, learning, and memory. And it's caused by a specific pathology in the brain that starts to accumulate 20 to 30 years before any signs of symptoms. For drug discovery, in the past, we've had to use mouse models where you put Alzheimer human genes into mice and they get the Alzheimer's pathology. And each experiment is one drug at a time in a mouse for a year or so. So we invented about 10 years ago, little mini human brain organoids, the size of a piece of rice. And in each one of these, what takes 30 years in a human for the pathology to accumulate and kill the nerve cells leading to Alzheimer's, we get that to happen in 6 weeks. So it's made drug discovery, screening for drugs, natural products, literally 100 times faster and 100 times cheaper. And I spent the last 7 years doing those screens, and I've identified over 300 known FDA drugs or natural products that stop the Alzheimer's pathology. And if we have safe versions of these and make combinations of them, then we can do clinical trials and see if we can learn how to stop the disease in its tracks. So in other words, these would be safe and affordable drugs or natural products we could use early in life to prevent the disease before someone gets into trouble with their memory.
For preventative healthcare perspective, what can people do to prevent themselves to have neurodegeneration disease?
So for lifestyle, I created an acronym, SHIELD, and S is for sleep. Try to get 7 to 8 hours or even a nap. Every time you go from deep sleep to dreaming and back and forth, you rinse the pathology from your brain, particularly the what's called the amyloid plaque, the sticky plaques that cause the disease. H is handling stress. Stress causes damage to the brain. So whether you meditate or find ways to relax, it's important to try to be mindful about handling stress. I is staying interactive with others. Loneliness increases risk for this disease. You need social stimulation to keep your brain healthy. E is exercise. And when you exercise at least 30 minutes per day and you get your blood flow going, you get your heart rate up, it actually helps your brain to clear the amyloid plaque and stop the inflammation. It also triggers the birth of new nerve cells in the parts of the brain that are most vulnerable to Alzheimer's disease. So you have new nerve cells there to help you. L is learn new things. When you learn new things, like read a documentary, learn an instrument or a language, just something new. Every time you make a new connection in the brain, a synapse, it's like money in the bank, because Alzheimer's is caused by the loss of synapses, the connections between neurons. And so the more synapses you make, the more you can lose before you get into trouble. So that's L. And D is most important. The D is the diet. Because if you keep the bacteria in your gut microbiome, trillions of bacteria, 8,000 strains, some of them are good for you, some of them are not. And when you have a plant-based diet, vegan diet, or even if you're not vegan, right, try to have a vegan food every single day, nuts, seeds, whole grains, fruits, vegetables. These crunchy things with fiber make the gut bacteria healthy. And somehow, when that happens, it allows for the plaque and amyloid in the brain to be removed, and it stops the neuroinflammation.
And what are the most important nutrients or vitamins for our brain?
Well, we found that there are three particular nutrients that, if you're low in them in your blood, will increase your risk for Alzheimer's. So one is the omega-3 fatty acids that you get in fish oil. I'm vegetarian, so I take a vegan version of those from algae. But either way, DHA, EPA are the two omega-3 fatty acids you want to have. If you're low on those, it increases your risk. Vitamin D3. And vitamin D3, I do 2,000 units per day. Some say 5,000. But I know my D3 levels only require me to take 2,000 units per day. And then the third one is methylfolate, which is one of the B vitamins. You can get that in a B complex. Because high homocysteine is bad for your brain. And if you take methylfolate, it brings the homocysteine levels down. So those are the three most important nutrients. And then we also work on supplements that can help, natural product supplements. And there we found, I released a supplement called CogniShield. It's also the main ingredient in Life Force Peak Cognition. It has four natural products. Two of them help clear the amyloid. The other two stop the neuroinflammation.
So it's a supplement we can take.
That's a supplement called CogniShield.
CogniShield.
Yeah. And we're doing the trial now, so we're not making any big claims yet. Because, you know, until you do trials, you shouldn't say much except it's designed to do this. But we'll know whether it works in trials soon. But for now, we put it out there because we feel people will benefit from it.
Yeah, and I do know you published more than 700 papers and also you're a New York Best Time Seller for writing about the neural health. From all the studies you run and trials you run, what are the most important thing you think our audience should know about their brain, about their neural functions?
Well, I think right now, the first thing you can do right now is shield. Make sure you get enough sleep, even if it takes a nap. Try not to get stressed out. Stay interactive, socially interactive. Learn new things. Exercise at least 30 minutes a day. It doesn't have to be crazy. Just get your heart rate. If you get your heart rate up 50% for 30 minutes a day, a brisk walk will do it. But number one is diet. Mediterranean diet, less red meat, as much of a plant-based diet as you can. No matter what else you're eating, just during the day say, I'm going to have a fruit or a vegetable or some nuts or seeds or a whole grain or a granola, because it's like medicine. It's literally like medicine for the brain, no matter what else you eat.
Yeah. And could you tell us a little bit about this concept you brought out about neural health score? What is it?
Well, at the McCann Center, we developed what's called a brain care score. So it's 21 questions, everything from your BMI, you know, and your A1C and your lipids and cholesterol, your blood pressure, onto questions about shield. How much do you sleep? How social are you? How much do you exercise? So it's a combination of your numbers and a combination of your lifestyle. And if you answer truthfully, you get a score. And then you can see where you're deficient and you work on that. Take the test again in another 2 months or 3 months. And the higher you get that brain care score, the more you know they're taking care of your brain every day.
To see in 10 years in horizon, what you are most excited about in the, you know, development of neural health?
In 10 years, we will use our family history and genetics to predict when we should get concerned about Alzheimer's pathology starting to begin in the brain, right? The Alzheimer's pathology begins 20 to 30 years before any symptoms of cognitive impairment or dementia, right? So 10 years from now, everyone will be getting a blood test at exactly the right age. For some people, it will be 30, some 40, some 50, some 60. And it will tell them whether they may be on their way to Alzheimer's. You're starting to make the amyloid plaque or the tangles. And then we will have safe and affordable drugs like the ones we're developing, including a new drug I'm developing called a gamma secretase modulator, or GSM. And they would be like the statins of Alzheimer's, the same way you take a cholesterol-managing drug like a statin to avoid heart disease. We will have readily available safe, affordable drugs, or even natural products that prevent Alzheimer's disease early in life. And I say safe and affordable because we want to democratize this process. We want early detection, early intervention to be available to everyone at an affordable cost.
Thank you, Rudy. Thank you for watching this new episode of the HumanWare Project. So that we can bring more amazing content to you, please like and subscribe. Your support means the world to us.